that men hunted, women gathered. That men hunted and brought home the bacon, while women stayed home and raised children. That men did something, while women did something else. That there was sexual division of labor for a very long time in human evolutionary history. That very model was tested with actual data. That's the paper I'm going to talk about today. Hi, this is Sang-Hee Lee, Department of Anthropology at University of California, Riverside. Welcome to my channel talking about human evolution, human adaptation. Please subscribe and set your alarm for new updates. Today's paper was published in Science Advances and was on the cover of this issue. Female Hunters of the Early Americas is the title of the paper, by a group of researchers from United States of America and Peru as well. So let's see what they say in the abstract, which will lay out the most important points that are made in this paper. The data come from the excavations at the Andean highland site of Willamaya Paksha, a 9,000-year-old human burial associated with hunting toolkit of stone projectile points and animal processing tools, and that this early hunter was a young adult female. With the research showing that there was a female hunter, the response would be, wow, or I'm sure it's an exceptional outlier that didn't happen in a common place, or third, of course, what else did you expect? Everybody did everything back in the day. Definitely it is a wow, that is why it is on the cover. And secondly, it is not an exceptional outlier. In fact, researchers looked at many other instances to show this was not an exceptional, but rather a commonplace practice back in the day. Let us look at the details of the paper. The site is about 9,000 years old, up in the Andean highlands. The site is 3,925 meters above sea level. That is 12,877 feet, very high. They found six individuals, and two of the individuals were associated with projectile points. One of the individuals, WMP6, is an adult female of 17 to 19 year old. And the burial was found with projectile points. That means the tip of either arrowheads or spears to be thrown from the distance. Unmodified flakes, retouched flakes, back knife, scrapers, choppers, burnishing stones, all of those relate to the various stages in hunting and processing animal meat. The human remains were estimated to be 17 to 19 year old based on dental development. All of her adult teeth were out, most of them were out, and the third molars, the wisdom teeth, were still in developing. That means that her growth was not completely finished, but she was an almost adult. How did they know it was a she? Unfortunately, the skeletal element that is most reliable for sex assessment, the pelvis, is not present. So sex assessment was done on the general morphology of the skeletal remains. Gracility, they looked more gracile, based on the sexually dimorphic peptides. That means that males and females show distinctly different patterns in their signals. These peptides are in the enamel of teeth. Peptides that are male diagnostic, that means that they are mostly found in men, entirely absent. And those that were present were all found in females. WMP1 individual is estimated to be male, slightly older. Based on dental wear, the older you get, your teeth are more worn. And according to the tooth wear pattern, the estimated age is between 25 and 30 years of age. And the sex assessment, again, is based on the general robusticity of the skeleton, as well as the peptides, the amelogenin peptides. And all the peptides that are found are male diagnostic ones, MLY, and no female diagnostic peptide, MLX. So the next question is this an unusual, exceptional case? So the researchers collected all the data, 429 individuals from 107 sites of the Americas. And of those, 27 sexed individuals from 18 sites were associated with hunting tools, hunters' burials. And of those 27 individuals from 18 sites, 11 individuals from 10 sites were identified as females. 16 individuals from 15 sites were identified as male. In other words, female hunters were not few in numbers, 11 females versus 16 males. And those female hunters were not clustered or gathered in a few number of sites. There were spread out 10 sites with females versus 15 sites with males. So in conclusion, female hunters were not exceptional, were not an outlier, and were not clustered in few sites. They were widespread and a common phenomenon throughout the Americas, at least early Holocene, 9,000 years ago. That sexual division of labor, especially regarding hunting, that there was not enough evidence to support the strict sexual division of labor as far as hunting is concerned, that possibility has been raised by several scholars. Actually, that particular model is supported by widespread ethnographic modern populations of hunter-gatherers collected by anthropologists. But we should remember, until mid-20th century, 1960s at least, most of the ethnographies were conducted by male anthropologists who are interested in male activities. What women did in those societies were either not interested or they were not welcomed into the female realm of a particular population. So it is interesting that the last 20 or 30 years, we start to see more ethnographies reporting on women hunters. Of course, not to mention that these ethnographic populations of the 20th century are not our prehistoric ancestors. These are not fossil humans. These are modern humans who are living in modern day and age, using the subsistence pattern that what we think continued since the prehistoric times. That does not make them living fossils for us to think that that's the way our ancestors lived. Coming up with innovative ways to test long-held ideas that have yet to be actually empirically evidenced, I look forward to more such research coming our way. Testing long-held ideas. That is the attraction of doing research. Thank you for watching the video today. Please like this video and let me know if you have any questions down in the comment section. Please subscribe to my channel talking about human evolution and human adaptation. Set your alarm for new updates. Please stay well, stay healthy, and I hope to see you again next time. Bye-bye.